For me, one of the fundamental unanswered questions is what and how many species are there in the ocean? My name is Greg Rouse. I'm a professor here of marine biology at Scripps Institution of Oceanography, University of California, San Diego. And I'm also a curator of one of our collections here at Scripps called the Benthic Invertebrate Collection. So a lot of the work my lab does is to discover species. The area we work on is mostly in the deep sea, and we really like working on places called hydrothermal vents, methane seeps. And what really got me into this game in the whole beginning in terms of moving here from Australia was whale falls. A whale carcass falling to the bottom of the sea is this massive pile of nutrients that is analogous to what we see at hydrothermal vents and methane seeps. And that led to the discovery of this a bone-eating worm called Ozodax, and I've spent many years studying that. Another real interest of mine are, and the only fish that I've ever worked on, are called sea dragons. The big discovery that came out of this project that was led by my student, who's now graduated, Josephine Stiller, was the discovery of a third sea dragon, the ruby sea dragon, which was in deeper water off Western Australia, which we were super excited about to find such a big new species. So we now have a website set up called Dragon Search. People who photograph sea dragons in the wild or to even take pictures of sea dragons in captivity, that they can upload those sea dragons, and we use machine learning to identify those sea dragons down to individual and get an understanding of sea dragon diversity through time, so it gets the public involved. So I love trying to tease out these stories of how things are related to and how we have species distributed the way they are.